So look at here. Please mute yourself, everyone. Any doubt is there, can unmute and speak. Don't worry about it. Yes. So look at here. For understanding of accuracy, accuracy nothing but is a measure of the difference between experimental value and mean value, or the mean value set of measurements. So look at here what is given. For understanding, we can take one example. For understanding, we'll take one example. So look at what example is given. So look at here. If the mean value of different measurements is close to the true value, it is close to the true value. It is close to the true value. The measurement is said to be accurate. For example, you can take, so look at here. Suppose a sample of compound containing contains 20.30%. For example, you can take one sample. A sample containing 20.3% will be there. 20.3% will be there of chloride. The chemical analysis of a sample by one method. For example, method A gives the mean value will be given 20.6%. Method A value is given 20.6% given. And chloride, while other method B is given 20.46. Okay, na? So total three values remember. One is, suppose a given sample of compound is given 20.30% is given. That is actual, nothing but experimental value. By solving, so student A can take 20.60% is given, and student B have 20.46% is given. Now what will do means difference between definition of accuracy, difference between true value and mean value. True value and mean value. So how much will be there? 20.60 minus 20.30. So how much difference we have? 0.3%. Like that, you can see the B student also. Difference between true value and mean value. So true value and mean value, you can check it. So true value and mean value, you can check it. So how much will be there? So their condition, by student A, we're getting 0.30% there. Student B, we're getting 0.16%. Therefore, the method B gives more accurate value than method B. So the accuracy also expresses the correctness of measurement. Understood? So you can take what is the given experimental value and mean value, that's true value and mean value, difference you can check it. So it will be coming 0%, it will be accurate, or 0.5, some more value will be the 0.6, 0.7 is there. That will be not accurate. Understood a value, understood a 0% error. Like for example, doing balancing. So one side you can put 1 kilo stone, another side you can put things. Both will be balancing equal. That will be accurate. Sometimes it may happen precision, nothing but high and low also. Now you can check it for the precision also. Precision is expressed the difference between measured value and arithmetic mean value, measured value and arithmetic mean value. Same thing, you can see the experiment value. So look at here, how much will be difference we have. Yes, for understanding that. Here also we can take, please mute your mics everyone. Here also you can take two compounds like method A, method B is there. Method A, percentage chlorine. Percentage chlorine, how much will be given? 20.60 will be there. And method B, 20.46 will be there. Same experiment you can follow. Yes. So here, 20 point like, thus the method A gives more precise data because of result difference will differ only plus or minus 0.05%. Then a plus or minus 0.05%. Otherwise, you can check it. For example, they given total 5 students will be there. Student A, student B, student C, like that student D also there. So look at here, what will be here. So accurate value is how much we have? Accurate value condition, mean value will be given 20.50, that will be mean value. While doing the experiment value, every experiment, for experiment 1, for experiment 2, and experiment 3, we have different values given. So like that you can see the student B, and student C, and student D also. So you can see the deviations of how much deviation we have. How much deviations also we have, you can check it. Please mute your mics, remaining students. Those are, I think, unmuted. Please mute yourself. I request everyone, please mute yourself, your mic. Yes. Otherwise, you can check it here in the graph. Look at here, student A, student B, student C, student D we have. Total 4 students we have. Along with the true value, how much will be there? 2.5 mg will be there, 50 mg will be there. True or mean value. So here, true value and mean value both will be same. So that you can say having good precision, good accuracy. But student B condition, mean value getting 20.5, that's but mean, that's but average, all students, that's but good accuracy. So mean value we're getting 20.5, that you can say good accuracy. But the precision will be having not accuracy, it will be having different values. This will be this one value, like that will be there. Student C condition, this all containing same mean value, like 20.20 will be there. That is a good precision, but not accuracy. That line we have, accuracy, whatever line we have, that you can say that we have accuracy. Next one is student D condition. Student D condition, we have both also poor. We have nothing but no accuracy, very low accuracy, and very low precision we have. So I think people understand it. Otherwise, you'll see the one more book also, what is the given explanation. Look at here. Every experimental measurement has some amount of uncertainty. Uncertainty, but not accurate value. It's associated with precision and accuracy. But you can't guess exact value. Sometimes it will be coming 0. Some less will be there and some more also there. For example, we have true value having 5 grams will be there. 5 grams, that will be true value. But when you're doing the measurement 1 and measurement 2, student A, they're getting 4.90 grams or 4.87 grams. So both will be near to same value only. That you can say good, precise. Other student B can check it. One is 4.86, 5.10. So both also not precise, not accurate. Accurate, but it will be near to 5 value. But student C getting 5.02 and 4.9. This will be both also precise and accurate. Understood? Precise means near to same value you can get. And accurate means exact value, near to true value, near to true value. So those uncertainty in the experimental or the calculated value will be indicated by the mentioning the number of significant figures. So with the help of significant figures, they are doing the whatever uncertainty we have. So for making accuracy purpose, they are doing their the help of significant figures, they're explaining. Now look at here. For calculating significant figures, we have some rules. We have some rules. These rules will be very, very important. Today's topic is significant figures. Significant figures. Otherwise, uncertainty numbers also. Uncertainty numbers. So today's topic. So look at here today's topic. What is the first one? Is we have some rules too. So rules for determining, the number of significant figures. So look at here. All non-zero digits are significant. So total we have three numbers with the three also non-zero numbers. So nothing but we have three significant figures. And the next condition, 0.25 ml is there. Only two digits only we have. That will be two significant figures. That is first rule. And second rule condition, zeros presenting to first non-zero digit. First non-zero digit are not significant. So here we have 0.03. So first zero will be not significant. Nothing but we have only one digit, one significant. Second condition, 0.005 will be there. So the left hand side, nothing but before first we have non-zeros. That okay now. That you can consider only, yes. So to total we have two significant figures like that. Next, third rule, zeros between two non-zero digits are significant. Yes. So here two non-zero digits will be there. Middle what will be there? Zero. Zeros between two non-zero digits. And then full that number also we have significant. But here 0.0103, only non-zeros between only, that you can call a significant. Like that you can say. Zeros at the end, at the right of the number of significant provide, they are on the right side of the decimal point. So decimal point will be there. Right side what we have? So zeros also will consider, that is also significant. So we have three significant numbers. So 200 also only one significant. So my example, you can check it. 100 condition, one significant. 100 point condition, decimal is there. So you can consider fully three significants. 100.0, four significants. Like that you can check it. Okay, na? For understanding more detail, we can see some more examples. Yes. Again, listen. Yes. In scientific notation, the large numbers or small numbers are expressed in n into 10 to the power of n format. N into 10 to the power of n format will be important. N into 10 to the power of n format. For example, number between 1.000 and 9.999 will be there. Multiplied or divided by 10. So then an experiment, what is the value you can get? Where n is a number between 1.00 and 9.9 will be there. So look at here for that. So n you can say exponent. So small n you can say exponent. Remember the point. For example, 138.42 is there. This number you can write 1.3842 into 10 to the power of 2. Nothing but decimal position will be changed. Here 138 point is there. Here 138 point is there. So now what I am doing? Decimal point are changing. Decimal point we are going to change this. So 138 point is there. So we are changing the decimal before 1. So nothing but to 2. numbers, two digits before you are putting decimal. Those condition you can write down 10 to the power of 2. Otherwise, three condition, 10 to the power of 3 you can do. Four condition, 10 to the power of 4. Like that. So decimal coming towards the left hand side. That's why you can write down 10 to the power of how many numbers before you are coming. So those many number you can write down. But here you can check it down. In the second row, 0.00138422 will be there. Decimal you are bringing right hand side. So here 0.00 is there. We are making 1 point and making. So 1 point, nothing but total how many digits we are coming left hand, right hand side? Total 4 digits. Nothing but 1.3842 into 10 to the power of minus 4. So remember everyone, 1 point. Decimal will be moving towards the left hand side. Decimal moving towards left hand side. No need to mention any negative value. Just you can write down how many numbers before you are coming. Those many number you can write down 10 to the power of. The exponent you can write down. The power you can write down. How many digits you are coming right hand side. 1 means 1, 2 means 2, 3 means 3, like that you can write down. But you can move the towards right hand side. Those condition you can mention clearly negative also. 1 condition minus 1, 2 condition minus 2, 3 condition minus 3, like that you can write down. So left hand side plus the right hand condition minus. It is remember clearly. Yes. To transform a larger than 9.999 is the two scientific rotation. What you can write down? So look at here. There is only one non-zero digits before the decimal point. Before the decimal point. If the decimal point is moved placed to the left hand side, that n you can write down x. So decimal moving towards left hand side, you can write down that how many numbers will be there. Moving towards left hand side, the left hand side is plus, right hand side is minus. What I said, that one is the given. The first one example, this is second one example. Next one, scientific figures. What is the definition? Look at here. Scientific figures, nothing but a number, all the certain digits, plus one doubtful digit. The digit is properly recorded measurement or known as scientific figure. Scientific figure. Nothing but you can maintain the whatever doubtful digits will be there, you can maintain the accurate. You can make it the correct. That only scientific figure. Scientific figure is a number, all the certain digits plus one doubtful digits. The digits in properly recorded measurement are known as scientific figure. Okay, na? We have some rules already told. All non-zero digits are scientific. So here all non-zero digits only we have. Take a count. The second rule is when a number is greater than one, all the zeros to the right of the decimal point, are scientific. So here 3.0 is there 2 and 9.017 is there 5. 42.00 will be there now. So 5. So remember all decimal points also considered as a scientific number. Third rule. For a number less than one, only zeros to the right of the first significant digit at the significant. But the zeros of the left of the first significant digits are not scientific. So look at here. Decimal before zero is there. Not consider. But left hand side zeros will not consider. Only right hand side zeros you can consider. Right hand side we have zeros. You can consider every number will be significant. But left hand side zeros will be there, will not consider. So left hand side here only one zero will be there. We can minus. Here three zeros will be, you can minus. Four zeros will be, you can make it less. Not minus. Less you can do. Here two zeros will be there, make it into less. That is the third rule. Fourth rule condition. So zeros became significant if it comes between two non-zero digits. So it will be there middle of zero will be there middle. First rule is right hand side. Second rule is right hand side. The third rule is left hand side. Fourth rule will be there, zeros will be there on the middle. So left hand side zeros will be there. How we are taking the scientific number? right hand side zeros will be there, how we are taking a scientific number. Middle zeros will be there, how we are taking scientific number. Very, very important. The same topic, what I am teaching, the scientific numbers will be coming in physics also. Physics also will discuss. Not, I think, I don't know. Maybe the first chapter, second chapter, we having same thing. Look at here. When adding or subtracting, the number of decimal places in the answer should be equal to the number of decimal places in the number with the least number of decimal place. Okay, na? When you are adding or subtracting condition, when you are adding or subtracting condition, you can follow this rule. Additions are subtract. Another sixth rule is when you're doing multiplication or division condition, follow sixth rule. So today's class homework, class notes, you can write down these rules. Put in heading, everyone, from here you can write down scientific notation or again experiment notation. This file already shared in our WhatsApp group. So you can refer the WhatsApp, this book, you can make your class notes. It is given clearly. Headings will be there. And where we can use the headings, the side headings will be given, and example also given. Clearly it is there. And after completion of the topic, we have some questions also. Nothing but exercise questions we have, and example questions also we have. Okay, now this also there. You can refer the book, fully book, you can understand what is there. Be very nice book, Amma. You can follow. Yes. Now look at here, once again, I'll repeat. Additions and subtraction. Look at here. So 3.21 is there. Total how many significant figures you have? 3 significant figures will be there. 2 decimal places will be there. With decimal places, nothing but after decimal, we have 2 places. Here, 2 significant will be having only 1 decimal place. Here, 5 significant will be there, only 3 decimal places. Nothing but what I am saying, in out of these 3 values, which is having least decimal place? Least decimal place, which one is having? The second one is. Nothing but after decimal, you can take only 1 digit, only 1 number you can take. Understood? So they given total 3 values is given. One is 3.21 is given. The next one is 1.5. And the next one is given 21.402. So these 3 values you can add. While doing addition condition, you can follow this rule. While doing the addition condition, follow this rule. So this rule, what is they giving? Means you can consider only least decimal number. So in this one, decimal place. So we can take a second one. Nothing but after decimal, you can consider only 1 digits. First one, we have 2 digits will be there. Second one, we have only 1. Third one, we have 3. And out of these 3, which will be least? So you can take consider second one. So since the term 1.5 invalid in the addition, so has only 1 decimal place. So the overall answer should be, so while adding condition, 26.112 is there. So you can report only 26.1 is accurate, like that. Okay, na? Yes. And the next condition, even you can do the subtracting condition as the same thing only. So look at here in multiplication and division condition, the number of significant figures in the answer should be same as that the number with what you can take least number significant figure you can take. Least number significant figure. You are taking significant figure, least significant figure, but taking here least decimal place. Where we can see the difference while doing the addition and subtraction condition. Then those conditions can follow least decimal place. While doing multiplication and division condition, you can follow least significant figure. Difference understood? Decimal place will be different. After decimal, you can consider least value you can consider. But here, you can consider throughout the examples, whatever you want. For example, here, this is containing 3 decimals we have. 3 significant figures we have. Here 2 will be there. Here 5 will be there. In this 3, which is having a least significant figures, the second one. The second one we have least decimal place as well as the least significant figure also. For example, some cases will be more significant figures will be there and least decimal also there. Okay, now that also will be a possibility. So look at here what is given for understanding. 3.3736 value will be there and 1.25 will be there and 4.22 is there. Okay, na?
Yes.
First condition it has four significant figures. Second condition, three significant figures. Okay, na? While doing the multiplication condition, answer how much you can get to 4.20, but you can consider only three significant concern only you can get to. Same type. Okay, na?
Yes.
And the seventh rule you can check it. When a number is round off, the number of significant figures is reduced. So if digit to be dropped is greater than five condition, less than five condition, or equal to five condition. Very, very important. Okay, na? So greater than five condition, what you can do? Last retaining the digit will be is increased by one. So and the last number increased by one. For example, 12.6 will be there. Six is greater than five. Those condition increased by one digit. Nothing but you can write down 13 round off number. Otherwise, the second one, less than five is there. Those condition, what you can do means, so you can see the last retaining digit will be left as it is the same thing. For example, 12.4 is there. So directly can write down 12. 12.4 is the directly can write down 12. So here we have two things. If the digit to be dropped is 5, the last remaining digit is increased by 1. If it is odd number and even number is there, odd condition. But left it has even. For example, here, look at here, 11.5 is rounded. So what you can write down? 12 you can write down, because the 5 is there, you can write down round off number. 12.5 is there, you can write down, 12 you can write down.
Yes.
Difference understood. So 11.5 condition, 11 is odd number. Odd number condition, you can should increase one digit. But even number condition, 12.5 condition, no need to increase, as it is, you can write down. So 13.5 is there, you can write down 14. 14.5 is there, you can write down 14 only. So even number condition, no need to change the value. Only odd number condition, you can increase the one value. Next point. Last digit is retained. Retained is increased by one. Only if the following digit is 5 and left. And is left such, the following digit will be 4. Okay, na? So if the following digit is 5, those conditions you can write down less by 1 you can do.
Yes.
Okay, na? Yes. These are the values. Total 7 rules will be there. The 7 rules will be very, very important. The 7 rules will be very, very important. With the help of these 7 rules, you can write down whatever values we have. Okay, na? So today's homework is this 5-7 rules you can write in classwork. Okay, na? Yes. Now you can check it for understanding. More understanding for the example of addition and subtraction. So look at here. The result cannot have more digits to the right of the decimal point than either of the original number. For example, you're having 12.11 is there. Those condition, here we have four significant numbers will be there, two decimal places will be there. But here, total we have three significant figures will be there. After decimal, we have only one digit face will be there. And here, total four significant numbers will be there. After decimal, we have three decimal places will be there. Understood? So this we are doing addition all. So first one we have total numbers will be 4 significants. So 2 decimal points, decimal places after decimal. Second one is 3 decimal places will be there. So we have only 1 decimal point. Third one is 4 decimal places will be there. Sorry, 4 significant numbers will be there. 3 decimal places will be there. So now out of these 3, which is having least decimal place? Second one only we have least decimal place. Nothing but after calculating all the values, you can take only least decimal place is 1. So by calculating all the values, you can getting 31.122 is there. You can write down 31.1. So you can take only 1 digit after decimal point. Understood? Even you can do the subtraction condition also, same thing you can follow. While doing the multiplication condition, multiplication or division, so the result must be reported with no more significant figures in the measurement. The few significant figures will be there. One is 2.5, next one is 1.25. Nothing but here we have 2 significant figures will be there, here 3 is there. So in this 2 is least. So after multiplication, we can consider only least significant value. So the result should not have more than 2 significant figures. So hence answer is 3.1. Understood? While doing the multiplication and division condition, you can follow least significant figure. While doing the addition and subtraction condition, you can follow least decimal place. Is it clear? Everyone? Students, understood any doubt we have?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes. So this is the main. So total we have 7 rules. Already I told 7 rules. Is yes, the 7 rules you can follow. So it will be given clearly. Yes. And we have some questions also in our NCERT book. So those are having NCERT book, please open your NCERT book. I will tell you questions also. How we will do the questions also. Okay, na? For example, yes, in this material we have questions. These all MCQ questions you can follow. Total 6 questions will be there. The 6 question we will do. Out of this, and even if they are given some NCERT textbook questions also there, given question numbers. So these questions numbers alone you can try. 1.16, 1. You people have NCERT book, ma? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then very good. NCERT textbook we have means no problem at all. Please open your NCERT book. We have this type of questions. You can check it. Okay, na? Yes. Very good. And we have last 4 minutes. So any doubts you can ask me. No doubts means you go for the question and answers. So class exercise is there and homework exercise also there. Okay, na? You'll do the class exercise. Total 6 questions will be there. You can ask any question, I will tell you. Which question you want? Which question you need, I will tell you. Tell me, ask. Okay, first question you will do. Write the significant figures in the following the compound. First question, under we have ABCD type, sub questions also we have. So first question, what is the answer? How many significant figures we have? 3 we have. Here also, 3. Here, 4. Here, 3. Here, 2. Here, 2. Here, 2. Here, 4. Here, 4. Here, 2. Like that. Understood? Easy only, na? Yes. Yes, very good. Very good. Nicely doing. So, easily can identify. So, the respect rule. This is first rule and the second rule that will be there. First one is non-digit. So, each one we have one example will be there. And the second question. The answers to the following problems. Yes. And one more thing, Amma. Already SAR announced. Next week we have MCQs test. Total 30 MCQs will be there. So these type model only. Already we have some questions. So these questions also can practice. So same this question also will repeat in test also. Same model also. So that's why whatever MCQ questions will be there, you can follow. Okay, na?
Yes.
Now look at here. The answer to the following problem in a standard experimental form. Standard experimental form. How much will be there? So this is one multiplication. This also another multiplication. So both also what will do? And addition also there. And addition also there. What is the value? One is we have 2 into 10 to the power of 13 is there. And the next one we have 1.5 into 10 to the power of 14 is there. Okay, na? Then what is the answer? What is the answer? We have doubt. How we can do the answer in the second question? Standard experimental value. So these condition, what will do means, so both also powers can make it into equal. For example, so this one already 2.0 into 10 to 13 is na, this decimal you can bring this side 0.2 you can make 0.2 into 10 to the power of 14 you can do. Both powers you can make it into equal. Okay, na? So here also 10 to the power of 14 is there, and here also 10 to the power of 14 is there. You can make it into separate. Then you can multiply. So how much are you getting? Addition. So you can add 2.0 is there, and next one is 1.5 is there. Both you can add. You can take a least digit also. You can take least digit also. You can take like that. Will be there. Time over, amma. Yes, yes. Very good. Yes. D option D. Very good. Nicely doing, Mahuran. So like that will be there. You can do. Time over, will be end the class. Thank you all. So you can do it next class. I'll repeat it.